Warning, warning. As a medical doctor, I must inform you that there are side effects to this coaching session. Beware. It may enhance your self-esteem, cause you to experience vibrant health, encounter long-term weight loss, heal damaged relationships. Warning, there are side effects to this coaching session. It may increase your enthusiasm for life and bring about hope. It may cause you to have productive and optimistic thinking. It could even help you not allow messed up people to ruin the rest of your life and help you realize the masterpiece that you are and empower you to be the boss of your brain. Warning, these side effects may be long-term. This is Dr. Isabel from doctoronamission.com.
Well, I'm going to take you on a little bit of a learning journey, which, you know, you may be way ahead of me, but this was something I had to learn. Let's talk about BPA. What the is this BPA stuff? Now, I've heard of it, BPA, free plastic, BPA, free cups to drink out of, all this and that. And I was like, oh, yeah, I got to make sure everything's BPA free, except I didn't even know what it was. So I had to become educated. So I'm just going to pass some of this on to you. You might be way ahead of me on all this kind of stuff. But, you know, I know some people out there might be in the same boat as me going, well, yeah, I've heard about it, but what are we talking about? What's going on here? Well, the BPA, okay, BPA is a chemical in plastics called Bisphenol A, very simply, okay? Now, the problem they found out with this chemical compound in plastics is over time it leaches. The chemical leaches out of the plastics. Another place that you find it a lot in is in cans. So as we talk about this, another problem is how much people are eating food out of cans these days because the cans have this BPA stuff in. So what's the deal with the BPA? Well, the biggest thing is that they have found, the research shows that what it does is it mimics our body hormones and specifically estrogen in the body. And so what it does, basically, I mean, it causes, it damages our reproductive organs, our reproductive effects on our body. It has a lot to do with causing more breast cancer, causing prostate cancer. It has been linked to decreasing sperm count in men. It's been linked to pretty much anything to do with sex hormones, reproductive organ health, all those kind of things. So if you care anything about your reproductive organs of your body, this is important. And I think we all do, especially, I mean, now they found this chemical to be in plastic baby bottles and teething toys, all this kind of stuff. You know what? Our girls are older now, and I had no idea 20 years ago about this stuff. So I wish I would have known. However, it's very, very important. So the thing about this BPA is it breaks down, and you know, if you've ever seen any of your plastic containers that you use for food storage, or, you know, microwave safe plastic containers, which means, yeah, it's not going to melt in the microwave, but it doesn't mean that it's safe health-wise because you're leaching out the chemicals into your food that you're going to be eating and all that kind of stuff. And let's not even talk about you not using your microwave. Well, we should, but not today. But this stuff just breaks down. It goes into our bodies, and it has definitely been proven to cause all kinds of cancers and bad stuff for us, and especially in our reproductive organs. So let's get BPA out. Okay, you find that all over the place. BPA free. Well, great. Okay, good, we know that. Now, here's the other thing. There's a couple other bisphenols. There's a bisphenol S and a bisphenol F. Those are the alternatives that are in there. Now, the thing about that right now is because all of a sudden we're going BPA free and we've got these other ones in there, the research right now, well, you know what? Are they safe or aren't they? Okay, I'm not here to say, well, whether they are or not. However, there's enough research showing the negative effects that they're just as bad as this, as this BPA. that should scare you. That should worry you. I don't want to be a scaremonger, but we need to be worried about this stuff. Now, there are others that say, oh, this is okay. It's all right. This is a good alternative. The thing we have to look at when we look at research is, well, who's paying for the research? Who's doing the research? Because the plastic companies are doing the research or the chemical companies are doing the research. Well, yeah, it's going to turn out to be good. So I guess right now the jury's out on this. It's kind of 50-50. However, if we are talking about what we are using that's going to be leaching into our body and causing cancers and bad defects, for us, for our children, for generations to come, the old saying, better safe than sorry, really applies right here. It really applies right there. So, well, what do we do? How do we get around this type of stuff? You know, well, definitely if you've got any of your plastic stuff that you're using for storage or container, I mean, try and stay away from food in cans, all right? Number one, stay away from stuff in cans because it leaches in the food. It's just not good. All right. So minimal stuff in cans, number one. The other is if you got plastic, and I'm not just going to say go ahead and throw away all your plastics and get glass, because I am going to talk about glass, but it's a little more expensive. So I am going to take that into account. However, if you can, yeah, get rid of it all and start using glass for all your storage. However, if you have and you can't afford to do that right now, I just say start cycling through it. And that's what we did is if you've got plastics that you can see are scratched or you can see are marked, they're faded. Well, that basically means that though if it doesn't look like it's pretty new, that means those chemicals are leaching out into your food. So I highly suggest you get rid of them and get yourself glass containers. There's plenty of them out there. You'll find them in all the basic stores out there. Glass containers. Yes, you can freeze in glass. I freeze stuff in glass. There are some rules about that. You can Google that. You just don't want to fill it to the top because it will expand. But start storing stuff in glass. If you got kids, I understand it's not as safe as plastic having kids, but you know what? We've got two things to look at it. We've got to, okay, are we going to go with the glass or am I going to stick with plastic knowing that this stuff is going to leach into the food and can cause all kinds of reproductive organ defects and cancers for my kids? I'll leave that one up to you. Okay, this has been Chef Michael here. I got to go, got to run. Glad I got the microphone on. But today we talked about bisphenol A, what it's all about, chemical compound that we got to get that's pretty much been taken out of plastics. However, now they've got alternatives and the jury's out on these. And I say, let's just not use any of this kind of stuff because it is going to cause a lot of baddies in our systems as far as chronic diseases and defects. And I don't want plastics mimicking my natural hormones. Okay? Call me crazy.